Welcome to InfOT. Today we will talk about the pediatric feeding disorder. Feeding is a complicated process that requires the successful interaction of our entire body and not just our mouths. For example, our muscles need to work perfectly, our tongue needs to move the food correctly, our nervous system needs to be in sync and ready to eat. All these systems and many more need to work together in order to feed ourselves. In pediatric feeding, the dyad, child and caregiver need also to be in sync with each other to achieve a successful feeding. If any of the previous mentioned systems doesn't work properly, or if anyone from the caregiver-child dyad has significant difficulty, then the child is at risk of developing a pediatric feeding disorder. Pediatric feeding disorder, or PFD for short, is defined as impaired oral intake that is not age appropriate and is associated with medical, nutritional, feeding skill and/or psychosocial dysfunction. The diagnostic criteria for PFD are the following. The child shows a difficulty with oral intake of nutrients, and this difficulty lasts at least 2 weeks, and in addition, the child exhibits either a medical, a nutritional, a feeding skill, or a psychosocial dysfunction. Second diagnostic criteria, an absence of the cognitive processes consistent with eating disorders and pattern of oral intake is not due to a lack of food or congruent with cultural norms. PFD is classified as acute and chronic. Acute PFD is when the difficulties are present for less than 3 months, and chronic PFD is when the symptoms are present for more than 3 months. Now, let's briefly review the four most important domains of PFD. Medical factors, diseases of the airway, impairments of the GI, the neurological system and other systems can cause PFD. Children with heart disease, with severe motor problems and cognitive delays, and neurodevelopmental disorders such as autism can be associated with PFD. For example, a child with a heart disease might be constantly hospitalized, and due to medications they take, they might often vomit, which results in a negative association with food, and therefore it could lead to PFD. Nutritional factors. Most of children with PFD have a restricted repertoire of food preferences, which puts them at risk for malnutrition, overnutrition, deficiency, and dehydration. For example, autistic children often struggle with drinking water, which could lead to severe dehydration. Feeding skills factors. When a child has a differentiated feeding experience due to illness, injury, or developmental delay, their feeding skills may be impacted. Feeding skills include oral sensory functioning, oral motor functioning, pharyngeal motor functioning. For example, a child might not understand when there is food in their mouth, have difficulty forming a bolus, and gag. This child could have an under-responsive oral sensory reaction. Psychosocial factors. As we mentioned before, their caregiver-child dyad is crucial for supporting the feeding procedure. Psychosocial factors in either the child, the caregiver, or both can result in PFD. Developmental factors such as motor, language, cognitive skills difficulties, mental and behavioral problems such as anxiety or stress, social influences, and environmental factors can contribute to the development of PFD. For example, a really stressed caregiver might struggle to feed their kid with severe motor and language deficits, and this could lead to symptoms of PFD. PFD is a disorder that needs to be addressed by a multidisciplinary team, as it can be affected by multiple factors. The healthcare team that can diagnose and help with PFD is usually consisted of a healthcare professional, therapists like OTs or CLPs, dietitians, psychologists and others. All information used in this video was found here. Thank you for watching InfOT. If you liked this video, feel free to like and subscribe.